Hi everyone, this is Jeff Watson. I want to talk to you today about these Egyptian obelisks and what the Holy Spirit has put upon my heart. It's distressing when I see truly what they represent. Take a minute and stop the video and read the history of these obelisks. They were the Binbin stones. They were hewn. They were designed to look like the Great Pyramids. And they were in homage to the sun gods. It's disturbing. So take your time as you go through this and read these next few sections to yourselves. Stop it. I want you to learn about the early history of these, what they represent both to the occultists as a phallic symbol, and how they come to be all over the world. So enjoy the music, stop the video, and I'll pick up after you've read the history and the meaning and the occultic meaning of what these obelisks are. So we see that the obelisk, whether it be Osiris, Ra, Set, whatever it is, Pan the goat god, it represents an occult meaning. And it represents a phallic fertility symbol, which is all over the world, brothers and sisters. It's everywhere. It literally means the shaft of Baal. The Bible warns us specifically against the worship of Baal. Doesn't it break your heart? It's amazing. So take a look and see for yourself these phallic symbols, these obelisks, and even the Muslim towers, the call to prayer of worship, represent the Muslims. The shaft of Baal, the same thing.
And
a
phallic.
Now, here we are in downtown Norfolk, and I want to now show you that these obelisks are on the top of our churches, brothers and sisters. They are on these so-called steeples of the churches. They have put an obelisk on the top of our churches, the very buildings in which we worship. The world you live in is not what you think. Open your eyes and see. Look at these things, okay? What? Look at this. It's an obelisk with a cross on top of it, on the top of a church building. And how many do you see? They're everywhere. The Holy Spirit has shown me this, and it's disturbing. I can't believe I've never put this together before, but look at our churches. I'm going to let you look through these churches, stop it, and you'll see a very common denominator. They look like an obelisk, and they have triangles, or the shape of the pyramids. We have an obelisk with a cross, and it continues up into the capstone, and on top is a cross. Over and over and over again, we see the same architecture in our churches. And it's not just the Catholic churches. So I don't want you out there saying, oh, it's the Catholics. It's not just the Catholic churches. It is all churches. Look, friends, open your spiritual minds and open your hearts. Look, the country church where you grew up, the steeple that everyone was so proud of, how about the Lutheran church down the street in our suburbs? What do we see? Or perhaps a Baptist congregation. Could be yours. It could be your very building. What's on top? What do we see over and over and over? Open your hearts. I'm not saying your building's evil. I'm not saying that you built it. I'm saying the roof under which you worship is a symbol of Pan the goat god. When you walk through those doors, those front doors, you look up. These so-called Masons, these so-called Illuminati, these elitists, you're sleeping, you're asleep. Open your eyes, my children, open your eyes. Open your hearts. The very symbol on which our Lord Jesus Christ was crucified is on top of an obelisk pyramid down to the very street signs that we have all around us. Triangles, pyramids, yield. Yes, it's time to yield. It's time to yield to the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the only salvation, the only way. It's not a church building. It's not a religion. What do we see in this monument to a tremendous man, Martin Luther King, one of my favorites in all of history, that lived his life and dedicated it for the freedom of others, not just for color, but for the freedom of all peoples. They made an obelisk. His monument is an obelisk, but what's missing at the top? There's no capstone. There's three sections. The bottom two sections are six stones each. The top section is five, with a steel rod coming through the top, which tells us that soon, someday, they will put the capstone on there. They're all in hexagram shapes. The six-sided hexagram. A monument to Dr. Martin Luther King, who is himself a monument for peace and love. And they turned it into a six-sided, 666 monument. It sickens me. Oh, they'll put the capstone on, and then it will be complete. The monument itself will say 666. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. So far as our national symbol, the Washington Monument. Look at it. The biggest obelisk in the world is in our nation's capital. And there the capstone, the pyramid. And what about the Vatican? 3 billion worshipers in the Catholic Church. And what do we have in the middle of Vatican Square? We have an occultist circle that represents the five-pointed star and a phallic symbol. But look, there's no capstone, brothers and sisters, but there will be someday when the Antichrist, the man of perdition, stands up and takes his place. These capstones will be put in place. But it's not just obelisks in the Vatican. I want you to take a look at the next few pictures. This is a building in the Vatican where they hold masses and meetings. What do you see? It doesn't need description. The serpent. That old serpent that beguiled Eve and fooled all the world. These beautiful children are sitting in this grand monument to the serpent, to Satan. Wake up, please. Please wake up. That's the outside of the building. Your time is up. There's no time. The children of God are getting these revelations all over the world. It's not just me. I'm nothing. I'm nothing. I'm the least of all servants. But I am telling you, this man is the only way out. You don't need religion. You need Jesus Christ. You need to love one another. The secret of this life is love. If you have anxiety, turn that anxiety to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. May the Lord Jesus bless you all, and may you all open your eyes.